fell asleep in the sky and woke up at a quarter to armistice with a tongue thick as poppies and a head that never had a reveal. Smashed as a bullet, spent as a watch, a sleepy-eyed sharpshooter saluting the cast of confetti of the big parade. I drank and dreamed, dreamed of drinking, while the Marantis went around at Claridge's and the bulls at the Parraca de Toros, and the girl who ran faster in red shoes swung past me like an electric planet. I could not remember the night without. I stopped dreaming. When I found the gun in my hands, and no one's watch chiming to wake me at 20,000 feet, the enemy crumpling far beneath me, and the wind in my ears screaming like a crowd, and I was cold, clear-headed, steady, and regret-free, leaving the way clear for my comrades as I disappeared into the dark. I met him on the road from nowhere to oblivion, where the sky comes down like a black lot, and tumbleweeds tackle and wrestle in the sand, and gas always costs 10 cents. Faded as a lobby card, he will offer to pay for the lift with the dust in his pockets and a wistful smile, just the list of a lance at a windmill, but the burden in his rucksack and his own light life. Expectant as the blank lines of a book, if you ferry him as far as the Pacific, he will vanish before the sun's burned down to the sea, the phantom hitchhiker of the painted desert thumbing his way into the roadside repute. Stop the car among the broken timbers of the Triassic, as heart shot red as a man with a promise in him, and he may take his leave with civility, and his scene stolen as absently as cigarettes, the ghost errant who wore his cynicism like a silver dollar on his sleeve. The girl he haunted, gone with her paints to Paris long ago. When I breathe, you can hear its restless feathers. The great winged wanderer of the sea lanes, locked inside my ribcage, like a world inside a speckled shell. The shim of the ice-white waves of the southern ocean and the shearing rise of the wind over seal-black rocks. In the distance, the silence made the language I speak first, before my throat closed with bird songs. In the red-breasted herald of northern spring, the thickets are full of small wings and sweet voices. The nests with delicate eggs dapple-dyed, only the stranger who can match me dancing and meet me balanced on the endless arc of air will hear the deeper breath I take, unfolding the full span of my ambition, holding steady between the sea and the stars. Twitching as storm-downed gulls on the rocks. Before dawn, we will search the torn nets of their faces for a bone pin of memory. A last will's clinging word, their driftwood ribs for a sea-glass jewel of love, too long on this shore. And the careless tide will whelm us, wrecked on the lanterns of our longing hearts. Out of the fog, like a grounding steamer, scatter twitching as storm-downed gulls on the rocks. Before dawn, we will search the torn nets of their faces for a bone pin of memory, a last will's clinging word, their driftwood ribs for a sea-glass jewel of love, too long on this shore. And the careless tide will whelm us, wrecked on the lanterns of our longing hearts. I'm not going to be able to do that. Out of the fog, like a grounding steamer, scatter twitching as storm-downed gulls on the rocks. Before dawn, we will search the torn nets of their faces for a bone pin of memory, a last will's clinging word, their driftwood ribs for a sea glass jewel of love, too long on this shore. And the careless tide will whelm us, wrecked on the lanterns of our longing hearts. On the century, the drag of their names under leather rotten earth, still churning to the surface 99 years on, our heels snag on skull flints, our heads on the poet's arcana, turning up shell shock and gas drills for coins, cups, and staves. Even the paper is soaked with ghosts, so much silence shoveled under lime. The children of Troy played Hector and Achilles in Apollo's wide-walled streets until they burned.
Thank you.
magic realist novel, we find the Firebird in the attic of your grandmother's diary, where the last poet she went to school with left it, burning like a near tomid. Before she was caught in the wind of rolling stock and ash, all these stories come to their tracks, stitching history scars. Its wings, a pageant of pomegranates. Its tail, the tears of a golden chain. Its rosins, for us, a story. No one else was left alive to tell. And whether between rafters the pages we are still listening, or whether in the last chapter we write ourselves out, you know the ending. Everyone does. Look. In the garret neither of us can pay rent on, your kid is kicking their heels in spring sunlight. The books are stacked like showgirls, and I can see those gold feathers shivering inside your shirt. Your great aunt told her story until she ran out of it. What you feed a firebird on had better have heat. While your kid crunches those red seeds like hard candy, we will rustle a nest up from string to exterior. Behind all this dry ink is still white and black fire. When the curtains came down, the bricks stood against the blue sky. One of us has a cocktail book of matches, and with all this rubbish from the last owner, we can surely find something to burn.